போச்சு அன்றைக்கி கிளாஸ் அவுட்டு. ஸ்கூட்டரை சரியா போட்டுனேனா இல்லையா? ஸோ ஹீ ஓன்லி ஹேஸ் ஜஸ்ட் ஹெல்த் லாக் அண்ட் ஹி வாஸ் ஈவன் ஹேங் ஹிம்செல். பட் கடைசியில் வந்து ஒரு டவுட், ஸோ ஹீ கேன் நாட் ஹாவ் இகலோக சுகம் பிகாஸ் இன் எவ்ரி திங் ஹி ஹாஸ் காட் டவுட். அண்ட் வாட் அபவுட் பரலோக சுகம்? இகலோகத்தையே டவுட் பண்ணாத ஆள் வந்து ஸ்கிரிப்சர்ஸ் அண்ட் புண்ணியம் அண்ட் பாவம் எங்கே அவனுக்கு கிடைக்க போகிறது? தெஃபோ ந அயம் லோகா ந பரஹா லோகா, தட் இஸ் தி எசன்ஸ். ஸோ அக்னஷ்ட அஸ்ரத்ததானஷ்ட சம்சயாத்மா ச வினஷ்யதி. ஆல் தீஸ் த்ரீ பீப்புள் ஹாவ் காட் நெகட்டிவ் ட்ரைட்ஸ் அண்ட் தேர்ஃபோர் தே பெரிஷ் இன் லைஃப். பட் ஹூ இஸ் தி வேர்ஸ்ட் ஒன்? சம்சயாத்மனா அயம் லோகா நாஸ்தி, ஹி கேன் நாட் என்ஜாய் திஸ் வேர்ல்ட். ந பரஹா லோகா, ஹி டசன்ட் ஹாவ் தி பரலோகா ஆல்சோ. தென் வாட் அபவுட் மோக்ஷான்? இது ரெண்டுமே இல்லாத போது மோக்ஷம் எங்கேனா? ஸோ ந சுகம், தெர் இஸ் நாட் ஈவன் மோக்ஷ சுகம். நத்திங் இஸ் பாசிபிள். அண்ட் தேர்ஃபோர் வாட் இஸ் தி வேர்ல்ட் எனிமி? சம்சயா. லைஃப் ரிக்வயர்ஸ் பேசிக் ட்ரஸ்ட். ட்ரஸ்ட் ஈவன் வித் ரிகார்ட் டு தி ஃபேமிலி மெம்பர்ஸ், ட்ரஸ்ட் வித் ரிகார்ட் டு அவர் ஆஃபீஸ் சப்பார்டினேட்ஸ், பிகாஸ் யூ ஹாவ் டு கிவ் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி. Delegation is involved. And if I don't have trust, what will happen? I have to do every job. So Swamiji used to tell, so this lady appoints a cook. Okay, sorry, ladies. Lady example. Therefore, she is not very sure whether he will do it properly and therefore walks behind. And இது இப்படி பண்ணாதே சொல்லி இதை எடுத்து அவளே போட்டுடுவான். அதுக்கப்புறம் தென் இது எப்படி பண்ணாதே சொல்லி, in fact, she will be doing almost the whole cooking, just giving the salary. And he says, amma nanna cook pandra, illa nanna saapittu. He will grow well. And similarly, you appoint a driver and sit behind in the car and drive the driver, hornady. So driver to vandu hornady ingra advice la kudupavan, indha edathila hornady and andha naalum kudra mukku varadhu hornady. இங்கே பிரேக் போடு, அங்கே ஒரு பஸ் வருது, தென் வை காண்ட் யூ ட்ரைவ்? தே கேனாட் ட்ரஸ்ட் தி ஹஸ்பண்ட், ட்ரஸ்ட் தி வைஃப், ட்ரஸ்ட் தி சில்ட்ரன், ட்ரஸ்ட் தேர் சபார்டினேட். சம் பேசிக் ட்ரஸ்ட் இஸ் ரிக்வயர்ட். அண்ட் ட்ரஸ்டிங் இஸ் அனவாய்டபிள். அண்ட் ட்ரஸ்டிங் இன்வால்வ்ஸ் ரிஸ்க் ஆல்சோ. அண்ட் பிகாஸ் தேர் இஸ் ரிஸ்க், இஃப் யூ ரெஃப்யூஸ் டு ட்ரஸ்ட், யூ கேனாட் லிவ் அட் ஆல். Because your children are growing and they go to various places. Enga pora enga pora kud paathun iruka mudiyuma? So we educate the children, and especially when they go abroad. How much you can follow what whom he is talking to, what he is doing, eduthukrana drug eduthukrana adha ellam pannithu sonna, it is impossible. And therefore trust is a very important value in life. It has got a risk factor, but at the same time it is inevitable risk factor. It is required in the case of Vedanta also. Whether Vedanta will give you benefit or not, how will you know? You come to attend the class and see whether there is any benefit. And if you say there is no benefit at all, I myself will say, kindly don't come. Therefore, up to that, there must be Shraddha. And therefore, na sukham samshayatmanah. Yoga sanyasta karmanam, jnana samchinna samshayam, atmavantanna karmani, nibadhranti dhananjaya. So here Krishna is summing up the sadhana and the phalam. A person has to go through three levels of sadhana. Yoga sanyasta karmanam. Yogaha means jnanam. And what is the jnanam? I am the Atma which is akarta. Akartra Atma jnanam is called here yoga. And by this yoga, a person gets detached from all action. Because actions belong to the body-mind complex. He allows the body-mind complex to function in the world, but he doesn't have over-attachment or identification, and therefore he has renounced the karma identification. This is the first stage. Then, jnana samchinna samshayam. Yoga sanyasta karmanam refers to the shravana stage. Then the next stage is jnana samchinna samshayam. He has negated all the doubts by gaining conviction through mananam. Jnanam means conviction. I should be convinced. I need not convince any other person. That is not relevant. And I cannot convince others also, because there are many people who don't want to be convinced. Therefore, I should be convinced of this knowledge. I should ask my own mind, are you convinced of this knowledge? And I should study until I am convinced. And therefore, the second stage is, he has removed all doubts through conviction. And the third stage is, Atmavantam. This is Nididhyasanam stage, and in which a person is alert to avoid forgetfulness of this teaching. This is not a teaching to be confined to this particular enclosure. The jnanam must be available in my day-to-day life. Yettu chorakai karikki udavadu. You have got wonderful notes, na? The note will get liberated. Anyway, it doesn't have bondage. That is a different thing. So, what is the use of cassette and note? It should be here for me to help me in crisis. So, Atmavan means the one who leads an alert life, the one who keeps this knowledge green during transaction. Apramattam. Jnana nishtam. This is the third stage. So, the one who has done the shravana, manana and nididhyasanam, him the karma cannot, karmani na nibadhananti. Just concluding, I will just take another 5 more minutes and conclude. Tasmadajnana sambhutam. Kritsam jnanasin atmanaha chitvainam samshayam yogam atishto tishtha bharata. Now Krishna gives direct advice to Arjuna. Arjuna, you also get rid of doubt, which is your worst enemy. I have given you 2 valid lessons. Follow karma yoga, purify the mind. Follow jnana yoga, enlighten your mind and be free. This is the basic teaching of Gita. Karma yoga is for purification. Jnana yoga is for enlightenment. So, having clearly grasped this teaching, may you remove the doubt regarding the sadhanas. Therefore, he says, jnana asina, by the sword of understanding, atmanaha samshayam chitva, may you destroy your doubt regarding karma yoga and jnana yoga sadhanas. Because Arjuna wanted to give up the karma and he wanted to go away. That means he wanted to go to jnana yoga without going through karma yoga. Krishna says, first to go through karma yoga, then alone jnana yoga. Therefore, having clearly grasped through the sword of knowledge, may you remove the doubt. What type of doubt?
Ajnana sambhutam. All doubts are products of ignorance. Any doubt is product of ignorance. That's why any doubt can go only by proper knowledge. Therefore, jnana asina, with the sword of knowledge, with the knife of knowledge, may you destroy the ignorance and ignorance-caused doubt. And what is the doubt? To fight or not? To be a grihastha or sannyasi? To take to karma yoga or jnana yoga? With regard to all these things, you remove all the doubts. And you have to remove your doubt because Kristam, it is in your own mind. Guru cannot do anything with regard to Shishya's mind. Guru can only assist, but the actual destruction should be done by the Shishya only. 10 people can take a person to water, but that person alone should drink water. I can give you supporting logic, scriptural quotations, experiential backing. I can only do the supporting part. With your intellect, you have to apply and remove your own doubt. Therefore, Hristam means you have to clean your doubting mind. I can only assist you. You have to clean. Therefore, chitva kristham samshayam. What should you do? Yogam atishta. May you take to karma yoga, which is the appropriate path for you for the time being. You are not fit for sannyasa now. Either postpone it or don't take it. But now you are not fit for sannyasa. Therefore, be a grihastha. Do your duty, even though it is bitter duty, unpleasant duty of killing your own kith and kin. You cannot avoid that. Therefore, uttishtha. Arjuna, get up, take your bow, take your arrow, and do your duty. With this, Krishna completes this present discourse. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnapurnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.
Sadashiva-samarambham Shankaracharya-madhyamam Asmadacharya-paryantam Vande Guru-paramparam Om. I will give you a summary of the 4th chapter of the Gita. The 4th chapter can be broadly classified into 3 portions. The first portion dealing with avatara, the incarnation of the Lord. The second topic is jnana karma sannyasaha, which is the central theme of the 4th chapter. And the third topic is jnana sadhana palani, the means of gaining knowledge and the benefits of gaining the self-knowledge. These are the 3 topics we find in the 4th chapter. I will discuss each topic briefly. The first I said is Ishvara Avataraha, which is discussed from verse number 1 up to verse number 15. And in this portion, Krishna shows the difference between Ishvara Avatara and Jiva Janma. Even though both of them superficially appear the same, because Lord also seems to have parents, Janmashtami, Rama Navami, etc., date of birth, and the Lord also grew up like any other human being. And since they look the same, we should know what is the technical difference between Jiva Janma and Ishvara Avatara. And we saw basically there are three differences. One is at the level of the cause of Avatara and Janma. The second is at the level of the very nature, Swarupa. And the third is with regard to the very purpose. So, Karana, Swarupa and Uddeshyam, Lakshyam, the purpose. At the Karana level, at the cause level, the difference we saw was that Jiva's Janma is caused by ignorance. It is because of ignorance Jiva has got the ego, and it is because of the ego he acquires Punya Papam, and it is because of Punya Papam he is forced to take this body. Therefore, for the Jiva, Janma is a fall. It is a clean fall because he is helpless. So, Ajnanam is the Karanam. Whereas in the case of Ishvara, the cause of Avatara is certainly not ignorant, but it is because of the Sarvajnatvam. It is the omniscience of the Lord as well as the compassion of the Lord. And therefore, it will not come under falling down, but Lord descends down to uplift the human being. So, when a person falls into a well, he has gone down. The one who wants to rescue this person, he also goes into the well. But there is a difference between them. One has fallen, another has descended, got down to help him out. And that is why, in the case of Ishvara, we use the word avataraha, avatarati, the one who comes down purely out of compassion. And by coming down, the Lord has to go through lot of worldly problems also. Rama had endless problems, Krishna had endless problems. And going through all of them, the Lord comes down. And therefore, it is jnanam. In the case of Jiva Janma, ajnanam is karanam. In the case of Ishvara Avatara, jnanam and karuna is the karanam. Then the second difference that we saw was with regard to the very nature, swarupam. And there I pointed out two differences. One is, since Jiva comes down because of ignorance, Jiva is bound. Jiva does not know his higher nature, and therefore Jiva suffers because of self-ignorance, and therefore he is Baddha Swarupaha. Which problem Ishvara doesn't have? For Ishvara, it is a leela, it is a sport, it is a game. Rama will never complain about his life. Krishna will never complain about his life. In fact, he was smiling all the time. Even while destroying Rakshasas, smilingly he destroyed, which made the Rakshasas more angry. Therefore, Baddha-swarupaha, Mukta-swarupaha. So, Bandha and Mukti is one difference. And the second is a purely technical difference. We saw that in the case of Jiva, the body is made out of the five elements. Maya does not directly produce the body. Maya produces the five elements, and through the five elements, Jiva Shariram is formed. Therefore, it is called Bhautika Shariram. Whereas in the case of Ishvara, it is supposed to be a direct conversion of Maya into Shariram. So, therefore, it is called Mayika Shariram. And that is why in the case of Narasimha, Avatara, etc., there is no time gap at all. 10 months the mother carrying, all such things. The pillar was broken. Suddenly Narasimha comes. Out of what? It is directly produced from Maya. Therefore, what is the second difference? Bhautika Shariram Jivasya, Mayika Shariram Avatarasya. Therefore, we call it Maya Manusha Veshaha. So, these are the two differences at the level of the Swarupam. Then, I talked about the difference at the level of the purpose. For what purpose they two come down? In the case of Jiva, the purpose of Janma is the exhaustion of Punya Papa. The exhaustion